Hello friends and welcome. In this video we are going to develop the MATLAB code for Gauss-Seidel method. Gauss-Seidel method is one of the iteration method used to solve the simultaneous equation. So this is the Gauss-Seidel method numerical for which we are going to write the MATLAB code. And the iteration method, that is Gauss-Seidel method or Jacobi method, will be converges only if we are having the equation as a diagonally dominant. That is, the diagonal term must be greater than the sum of other elements. Then and only we get that the methods are converging. So if you observe these three equations, these equations are not diagonally dominant. That is, we need to change the rows. So by applying the partial pivoting, we can get these three new equations as first equation, second and third. Now if you observe, these equations are diagonally dominant. That is, the value of 4 is greater than 2 plus 1, that is 3. This diagonal element value of second equation 3 is greater than 1 plus 1, that is 2. And the third element value 5 is greater than 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So now we are having the equation in the diagonally dominant form. So this method will be converging and we will get the solution. So to get the solution, first we need to convert this equation in form of x, y and z simultaneously. So equation 1 will be written in the form of x, then equation 2 will be written in the form of y, and equation 3 will be written in the form of z. So we will get these three equations. Then initially we have to put the y and z value as a 0, then we will get the new value of x. So this new value of x will be immediately replacing in equation number 2. So the new value of x and z value as a 0, we need to put in equation number 2 to get the new value of y. Then this new value of x and new value of y will be put in equation number 3 to get the new value of z, and the same process is repeated to get the solution. So for these equations, we are going to write the MATLAB code. So let's open the MATLAB, and for MATLAB, as we are converting the equation in forms of x, y and z, so we are writing the MATLAB code in the form of function and not in the form of the matrices. Okay, so let's open the MATLAB window. So now again, this is the Gauss-Seidel program is written. Three magical words are used: CLC, clear all and close all. Now we are taking the input from the user as the equation, that is a function of x, y and z simultaneously. And the variable used as fx for x equation, fy for y equation and fz for the third equation as a z. You may use any other variable, but same variables you need to repeat in this for loop. So remember here, this fx, fy and fz are only the variables are used. And then the input syntax is used to take the equation as the input from the user. Message for the user to enter the function of fx, then here it must be a fy and here it must be fz. Okay, so enter the function as fx, fy means x equation, y equation and z equation. As the x equation containing variable y and z, so I have written here y comma z. Y equation containing the variables x and z, so it is written here x and z, and z equation containing the variable x and y. Okay, then we are taking the number of iteration as the input from the user. So the variable used as a n, then initial values of x will be taken as a 0. So this is again the initialization. Initially we are taking the values of x, y and z as a 0. Then we are performing the operations for the number of times. So we have to use for I is equal to 1 to n. And in that loop, we are using x is equal to fx, y comma z. So this, whatever the values of x equation will be assigned to x variable. Same, the values for y equation will be assigned to variable y. And the values of z equation will be assigned to variable z. Then we are going to print the values of x, y and z. So for first syntax, I have used the slash n to print the x value on the new line. Then the y and z value will be printed next to the x. So that's why here it is used as a slash t. So slash t is used for trap. You may, these three printf syntax are written on the separate line. You may write in the same lines also, no issue. So how this loop works, when our I value is 1, then it takes the x value, y value and z value as a 0. That value will be put in the inputted equation or a function, and then it calculate it. So whatever the after calculation the value will be get, it will assign to value x. Then that value x and the previous value of z will be considered, and this value is again put in the given equation of y. Then it again calculate the new value of y. Then again the x value and y value will be considered, and it will be put in the given equation of z, and it will be calculate the z value. Then it will print all three values. Again the increment in I will be takes place, and the new values of x, y, z are put in the given equations, and this process is repeated for the number of times. So in this way you can be able to write the MATLAB code. Now we are going to run this MATLAB code for that given equations. So let's run this program now. So click on this run icon, and this file already I have saved, so it is directly open the command window. Click on this command window. Now you can see here it is asked me to enter function fx, y, comma, z. So while entering the function, you can use the inline syntax or at the rate x symbol. So I am going to use at the rate symbol and in bracket, as this x equation containing the two variables y and z. So we have to use here two variables y, comma, z. So remember, when you use the at the rate symbol, then whatever the variables are present in that equation, that variables you have to use in bracket. So you can see here also, in this x equation there is one variable as a y and other variable as a z. So this y comma z we have to use. For y equation x and z variable, and for z equation x and y variable, and these values we have to input as the equation. So 16 minus y minus 2z by 4. Okay, so remember these equations, we are going to use this equation as an input. Now at the rate y comma z is used, and in second bracket we have to input that equation, that is 16 minus y minus 2z. So 2z will be written as 2 into z. Again remember, you have to use the multiplication symbol in between these two. If you write 2z continuously, it gives you error. Okay, so always write it as a 2 into z, then bracket complete and whole divided by 4. So this is the x equation. Now give the enter key. For second equation again write at the rate, then in bracket y equation containing the variable x and z. So you have to write in bracket x comma z, then second bracket, the y equation is 1 by 3 10 minus x minus z. So we have to write 10 minus x minus z, bracket complete and whole divided by 3. Then give the enter. The z equation will be written as again at the rate, the z equation containing the variable x and y. So you have to write x comma y, then in second bracket the equation as 12 minus x minus 2y, so 2 into y, then bracket complete and whole divided by 5. And when you hit the enter key, you have to enter the number of iterations. So generally we will be get the result in 6 to 8 iterations, but for safety you can use the number of iteration as a 10, 15 or 20. So I'm going to use the iteration number as a 10, and when you hit the enter key you can get the results. So you can see here the x value, and as we are using the slash n, so by giving space y value and then giving space z value is printed. So this is the iteration number 1 value, iteration number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So up to iteration number 10 value is printed. And if you observe, after 6 to 7 iteration the same value is repeated. So For this numerical, only 6 iterations are sufficient to get the result. So let's check our calculated values. So these are our calculated values. 6 iterations, we are getting these 3 values x, y, and z, and same result will be get the by using the MATLAB program. Now for this program, again the same solver syntax is used, and we need to verify these answers using the solver. So for solver, again we need to use to define A matrix and B matrix. So let's give me the comment solver. First we need to input the A matrix and B matrix. So A is equal to in square bracket. Now the A matrix is, so after pivoting whatever the equations you will be get, so this is the left hand side matrix, that is a 4 1 2, okay, then 1 3 1 and 1 2 5, these are the A matrix, and 16 10 12 is the B matrix. So these values we have to input. A value is 4 comma 1 comma. The first row is complete, then use the semicolon. Then second row is 1 comma 3 comma 1. Then as the second row is complete, give semicolon. Then third row is 1 2 and 5. Now I am using the semicolon, so I don't want to print the A matrix again. And now you need to define the B matrix. So B is equal to, again in square bracket, the values are 16, 10 and 12. So 16, give semicolon, then 10, give semicolon and 12. Then again using the semicolon, hit the enter key. Then the solver syntax is inverse of A into B, and the answer will be assigned to variable X. So I'm going to use X is equal to inverse, so INV is the syntax for inverse, and inverse of matrix A, then multiplied by B matrix. And when you hit the enter key, you will be get the result, that is 3, 2, and 1. So these are the final answers. By iterative method, you will be get the approximate results. By direct method, you will be get the exact results. So I hope it is clear for all of you. If you are having any queries or questions, please ask. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.